Stopping an offense on third down is one of the most important jobs of a defense. Being able to force another team to punt or to settle for a field goal is absolutely crucial for long-term success. Last season, there was one defense that was objectively better than everybody else. That team was the New England Patriots. They were so good at preventing third down conversions that they were actually the greatest defense of all time in this ability. This absolute domination is something I want to focus on for this video. I want to see how they did it, and I want to answer the crucial question if this dominance will continue into next season. To start this breakdown, I went through and tracked every single third down attempt that this defense faced. For this video, we'll focus on what they did against the pass, as the run stops were primarily made up of short yard situations. What amazed me while going through this film was the emphasis the Patriots had on sticking with man coverage with a single high safety. Cover one robber was the primary coverage this defense faced. While people think of Bill Belichick as a game plan to take away your top weapon type of guy, this was actually not the case last season. I expected him to use more bracket coverage in these situations where the number two cornerback and the safety would combo together to eliminate a star receiver. However, Belichick simply didn't do that. He uses all-pro cornerback Stephon Gilmore in star coverage, sending him against the offense's top receiving threat. He had him trail him all across the entire field, including the slot, and he eliminated that receiver from the game plan. After that, he used a robber defender, typically Devin McCourty, to cut off crossing routes, and his deep safety Daron Harmon to patrol the center of the defense. As I said a moment ago, I truthfully expected more bracket coverage last season. Just so we're on the same page, here are the three that I typically look for. First, you have cover two cone. What happens is that with cover two cone, you as a defense decide that the number one receiver on the outside is the quarterback's primary target. For a quarterback that loves a certain receiver on this down and distance, like how Matt Ryan loves Julio Jones, this is a great call to take away that man. Now, you do sacrifice your willingness of the safeties to help on the other routes, but this is great for how you can deal with the star receiver. Now, if the slot receiver is the offense's main target on this type of play, like how Tom Brady loved Julian Edelman, cover two deuce could be a great weapon against that team. Your focus is the number two receiver on both sides of the field. Obviously, this has the same risk as cover two cone, since you aren't playing with a deep or robber safety any longer. Finally, the last coverage that the Patriots used a few times this season was cover two Mike. This is a coverage where they doubled the number three receiver with a Mike linebacker or strong safety. This is great when the offense has a tight end or running back as the primary target. Think of guys like Jason Witten, who is impossible to stop on third down, or a guy like Christian McCaffrey out of the backfield. You obviously don't want to cover either of these one-on-one. On this play though, this was just a simple cover one robber call with a deep safety while the underneath safety sat looking for crossers. Some also call this coverage cover two lurk, but for the sake of this video, I'm going to call it cover one robber because robbing the offense is literally the purpose of this defense. After the snap, number 32 Devin McCourty helped guard against crossing routes while Daron Harmon played as a single high safety. This put Stephon Gilmore and the other cornerbacks in man-to-man coverage. Even though Tyler Boyd had a good initial release forcing Gilmore backwards, Gilmore is elite at recovering and knowing what an offense is trying to do. He got back to the inside hip of his receiver, cut him off by the 43-yard line, and twisted his body backwards to intercept this pass. What you'll notice from this play was that Gilmore had his receiver beat as soon as he fully recovered after the release. However, Dalton was attempting to throw this ball with anticipation. He expected Boyd to win one-on-one, and Boyd simply couldn't do that. Plays like this one are exactly why Gilmore is an all-pro cornerback. Here's another example of this dominance against the Giants back in Week 5. It's really amazing to see what Gilmore did in these high-pressure situations. Based on his film study, Gilmore knew exactly what the play was coming from the Giants, and he shut it down with ease. Before the snap, the Giants lined up in shotgun using a 3-by-1 formation. On the field side, you have a vertical switch concept designed to create rubs on the opposing defenders. Meanwhile, on the boundary side, you have Cody Latimer running a slant route against Stephon Gilmore. On this play, Gilmore was playing an off-man coverage with inside leverage in order to protect against this very route. Seeing this leverage and how Gilmore was positioned before the snap, Daniel Jones thought he could squeeze the ball to his receiver. He was sorely mistaken on this one. Before the ball was even out, Gilmore drove on the pass and he was already at Latimer's inside shoulder by the time the ball even left Jones' fingertips. This should have been an interception. This was still an awesome play regardless, and it was definitely a learning moment for this rookie quarterback. Before we move on from this play, the last thing I want you to note is that the defense actually rushed 5 on this one. They were trying to force Jones to get the ball out early and not look for the other opportunities deep. And that's exactly what happened here. Being able to pair your pass rush to the play of the secondary is so incredibly crucial, and the Patriots routinely did that all last season. Now, while winning on passes against a rookie or Andy Dalton is one thing, but what about against an elite quarterback like Patrick Mahomes? Gilmore did just that in the second quarter when he faced Sammy Watkins one-on-one. Focus on him at the bottom of your screen. On this play, Mahomes attempted to throw a back shoulder fade. He placed it inside of his receiver in order to allow Watkins to adjust to the throw and win inside. However, Gilmer wasn't having it. Even though he was pushed past this route initially, he still timed his hand strike perfectly and was able to break it up so that Watkins couldn't bring it in. As I mentioned earlier, I tracked every single play and here's what I discovered. The Patriots loved using man coverage last season. They used it on 84% of their third down snaps in 2019. In man, they allowed a conversion rate of 21%, they allowed just over 4 yards per attempt, and they also allowed a measly 0.6 adjusted net yards per attempt on these downs. For context, the average success rate on passes on third down was 36% last season. Clearly, only allowing a 21% conversion rate is significantly better. In addition to the small number of yards allowed through the air, they only allowed 4 touchdowns, but also intercepted opposing quarterbacks a whopping 9 times. Speaking of man coverage and the Patriots' dominance, it was Cover 1 that made up a large portion of their play calls. Cover 1 Robert, like I said before, was such a big component of this. Pay close attention to the yards per attempt allowed and the adjusted net yards per attempt allowed in this coverage. Yes, that's not a typo. The adjusted net yards per attempt was negative in 2019. You just never see this. You expect that number to be at 5 or 6, maybe even closer to 7, but not negative. This simply means that the Patriots literally eliminated some quarterbacks from this planet. This is a great stat that clearly shows their dominance. Now, the final chart I want to show you is how each quarterback fared against this defense. Now, there is a ton of data on this screen, but the key takeaway is that only 3 quarterbacks throughout the entire 2019 season actually played well against this defense out of the 16. Those 3 were Deshaun Watson, Ben Roethlisberger, and Lamar Jackson. The rest were either below average like Carson Wentz and Baker Mayfield, or they were just straight up bad like Sam Darnold, Luke Falk, or Andy Dalton. Even Patrick Mahomes, who was amazing on third downs against the vast majority of teams last year, didn't play all too well in this crucial down against this defense. The last thing I'm going to say about this screen is that before we blow this stat out of proportion, third down conversions aren't solely on the quarterback. It's also very indicative of how the team performed as well. The other thing I'm going to say is that sample size is obviously a big issue here. If each quarterback gets 10 third down attempts per game, that's not exactly a statistically significant sample size. Even though this is the case, I think it's still kind of fun to look at these metrics just to see how poorly some quarterbacks played against this team. Now, from the list on the previous screen, I want to focus on Deshaun Watson. Not only did he throw for 12 plus yards per attempt and converted 50% of his downs, but his adjusted net yards per attempt was close to 15. That is insanely good, and it was against literally the best third down defense in NFL history. He definitely deserves a shout out. Let's look at a couple plays to see how exactly he did that. In the third quarter, the Texans had an 11-point lead and were faced with a 3rd and 10. The Patriots dropped into cover 2 man with 2 safeties deep. The safety at the top of your screen was looking for Dake and crossing routes at the sticks, while the safety on the right was playing over the top of DeAndre Hopkins. Since the left safety allowed Kenny Stills to run a post route unimpeded, this put Stills into a 1-on-1 situation against Jonathan Jones. After the snap, Deshaun Watson took a deep 12-yard drop, stepped forward, and then he threw the ball deep into the back of the end zone. This was a perfect throw to beat this coverage, and it allowed Stills to bring it in for the 35-yard touchdown. Looking at all their third down attempts, this was actually the 2nd longest passing play this defense allowed all season. Now jumping forward to the 4th quarter from the same game, this gives us a 3rd and medium situation. The Texans were up 12 points. Earlier in this breakdown, I showed that slant route from the Giants against Gilmore, and in this one, we have a slant route run by DeAndre Hopkins, but this time Gilmore was in press coverage. Similar to that last one, the Patriots were also playing cover 1 on this one. Instead of rushing 5 and forcing another early throw like they did against the Giants, the game plan versus the Texans was a bit different. They played a lot more cover 1 spy using a defensive back to spy Watson in order to keep him inside the pocket. On this one, Terrence Brooks was the spy, making sure Watson didn't look to scramble. While this is background information, it does affect the way this play's run. Instead of doubling up Hopkins on the outside, and with Houston having a mobile quarterback, this completely changes the game plan. It allows them to create these one-on-one opportunities. Then, when you combine that with having an elite wide receiver like DeAndre Hopkins, it makes your offense work extremely well. This route that Hopkins ran is called a box slant. This is a modification on a basic slant route. Instead of taking inside leverage upon your release, Hopkins' goal is to stem outside, attacking Gilmore's outside shoulder, trying to force him to flip his hips or at the very least step backwards and open the path underneath. Now, if Gilmore does not do this, then Hopkins will use his hand fighting skills, which he has perfected over the course of his career. He'll use these to break back inside to create a window. Plus, then you add in his post-break acceleration like he did here, and this snap was run to perfection. He fluidly rolled his hips back towards the center of the field, and he won inside to create a window for this throw. Now, while these plays do go directly against the theme of this video that this defense was elite all season, there honestly weren't many more like this. The vast majority of the offense they faced, the Patriots tore them apart with stunts, great coverage, and perfect execution. Even when teams used stacked alignments, motions before the snap, and rub concepts, the Patriots passed those routes off to perfection. They had very simple replace rules for crossing routes where the robber defender or the deep safety would take over for the trailing cornerback, and that trailing cornerback would then take over for that respective position. This is what forced offenses into those horrible third and long situations. Then when they had you deep on your own downs, they then ran cover zero, blitzing the hell out of the quarterback, which forced teams into bad decisions. Even when the Patriots played zone coverage, they rallied underneath and made form tackles to prevent against first downs through the air. All season long, I just kept writing down, this was an incredibly disciplined defense. The level of execution was simply amazing. As I mentioned at the start of this breakdown, this defense pretty much told you up front exactly what they were trying to do. They said if you can beat us one-on-one on low percentage throws to the outside, or if you have a good scheme design or simply get lucky, the Patriots were fine with allowing conversion. They knew they could make up for it with incredible execution, and they did that all season. By now, it's pretty clear that the Patriots' defense was exceptional last season. Let's go back and answer the question I posed at the beginning of this breakdown. Will they be able to maintain that next season? Well, looking at who they lost to various trades, cap casualties, and COVID opt-outs, it might be a bit harder next year. The Patriots lost Danny Shelton, who is an underrated nose tackle. They lost linebackers Kyle Vannoy and Jamie Collins, and they traded free safety Daron Harmon to the Lions. Meanwhile, both Patrick Chung and Dante Hightower opted out for the season due to concerns over COVID. Without these players, it'll certainly make it more difficult to repeat this incredible feat. Some of these players have just been a centerpiece for this defense for a very long time. Now, while this may be the case, the Patriots were pretty aggressive in the most recent NFL draft at targeting defensive players. They drafted safety Kyle Duggar, they drafted linebacker Josh Uche in the second round, and they also took Anfernee Jennings, an edge rusher out of Alabama, in the third. While none of these players are premier talents at their respective positions, they'll each have roles in this defense. I expect them, and especially a guy like Josh Uche from Michigan, to get a lot of playing time next season. He's literally a perfect linebacker edge prospect for this hybrid style defense. So, the question we can go back to is, will the Patriots sustain that incredible level of dominance? My honest answer is unfortunately no. This answer comes in two parts. To have the lowest third down conversion rate of all time, you have to be elite. You also have to be very lucky. This team is statistically due for regression. The other thing you have to note is that with all these losses that I just broke down in the shortened offseason, this team won't be as gelled as they were last year. Now, the question is, how low will they drop? Will they actually be bad next season? To me, that answer is definitely no. This is still Bill Belichick we're talking about, and having star talents of the McCourty brothers plus Stephon Gilmore, this definitely shouldn't happen. Again, they won't be as good as they were last year, but if they regress to say top 10 or top 12, I do think that's pretty reasonable. To wrap up this video, I spent a lot of time discussing the main reasons why this defense was so good last season. It starts with simplicity and execution. They were so well disciplined at running cover one and mainly cover one robber, it was impossible to beat them consistently through the air. Meanwhile, having a cornerback like Stephon Gilmore is a human cheat code for this defense. He can cover star receivers, he can cover tight ends, and he's so incredibly intelligent that he's always in position to make plays. For as much as we think of Bill Belichick and Tom Brady being tied together, it was this defense that was the key point last season. This defense is what allowed them to win 12 games, and it was this defense that allowed them to win the AFC East Championship for the 11th straight season. Well, that's all I have for you in this one. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you subscribe to my channel. Also, if you support me on my Patreon, make sure you download my fantasy football rankings in the link below. All it takes is just a $1 donation, and you get access to those files, which I'll gladly update all summer long. With the NFL season officially starting, I should have one more video out next week, and then we'll finally enter the NFL regular season. Until then, take care of yourself, and you can follow me on Twitter at Samuel R. Gold.